In this tutorial, you'll learn how to draw sketch, how to add shadows and highlights in Adobe Illustrator, and how to create custom brushes. You'll learn time-saving tracing method and will understand how to use clipping mask. You can download my sketch, colors, and practice everything that I'll show you today. You are watching TNT Tutorials, let's move on! Always start with general shapes. Make a quick and rough sketch of what you want to draw. Then work on the silhouette. It should be interesting and not too confusing. At this stage, you don't have to think about what will be inside of the silhouette. We need to work on the proportions. Use the references for your illustrations. Observe everything that can help you to draw. For example, when you draw a hand, start with the shoulder. It's a big circle. Then set the direction of hand. Draw the first line. Then again the circle. And again the same line. The length of the second line is the same as the first. The third line is shorter than previous two. Then look at the human anatomy and simplify it. Look how I draw face. The horizontal line is right in the center. It's the location of the eyes. The vertical line helps maintain symmetry and shows the direction of the head. I have tutorials on how to draw faces and poses. Take a look at them if you want to know more about how to draw faster and more effectively. It's important not to forget the silhouette even in the late stages of the work. Make sure that the composition is complete and nothing prevents you from perceiving it. All the details and small elements are the final part of the drawing. To draw better, always check the references. Look for a photo for everything you want to draw. Save photos with poses, hands, faces, hair, and anything else you might need. Meanwhile, sketch is almost done. Press thumbs up and subscribe if you're ready to create an illustration using my method in Adobe Illustrator. Select Web. Enter 2000 in both windows and click on Create. You can download my sketch by the link in the video description. Click on File, Place, and click here to place it ideally. Lock sketch layer and create a new layer for tracing. First that you need to know about tracing is that you should trace with overlapping. Notice that I make overlapping absolutely everywhere. This is crucial for a method that you'll learn today. There's a few tracing and coloring methods in Illustrator. I've created many illustrations with this software, and I will share the best method with you today. I use it all the time since I've discovered it and even made it better. With my tracing and coloring method, you should learn three crucial steps. First, trace with the pen tool using overlapping, as I already told you. You can also use the pencil tool if you have a tablet. Pick the pencil tool and press Enter to open adjustments. There you'll have a slider which will allow you to create accurate lines with corners or smooth wavy lines. I personally do everything using the tablet. It's totally up to you which one to choose, but you should know that there's also a brush tool available in Illustrator, and I'll show you how to use it in the future videos. Second crucial step is a correct deleting of all unneeded lines that we'll have after we'll trace everything. There's nothing wrong with the shape builder, but it just don't work here properly. Third step is coloring. I experimented with many approaches and I want you to save your time and use the best coloring method which I'll show you today. After these three steps, we'll apply shadows and highlights using the clipping mask, and we'll make a custom brush to make usual lines look like a pencil sketch. With the custom brush, your computer might run a bit slower, so keep that in mind and don't worry about that. I also recommend you to apply custom brush after all work will be done. This will save your time and make your life easier. For those who are new to Illustrator, there's only a few hints that I use over and over to trace this sketch. Press P to use the pen tool. To make a sharp corner, hold Alt or Option key and drag a handle to adjust direction. To deselect path, hold Ctrl or Command and click somewhere. And to change lines after you've created them with the pen tool, press A to use the direct selection tool. With the direct selection tool, you can move points and play with handles. Also notice that I don't trace each shape separately. I simply follow the drawing line by line. Practice more and you'll trace extremely fast with this easy tracing method. For me, it can take 10 or 15 minutes to finish a sketch like this. Don't rush, relax and take your time. Meanwhile, tracing is done. Notice that all lines are overlapping, this is very important. Create a rectangle according to this artboard. Press M to use the rectangle tool. select All Lines and open Properties panel. Go to Pathfinder, click on More Options, and select Outline. Everything's become invisible, so we need to select Lines, apply Stroke Width and Color again. Right-click on Lines and select Ungroup. Now I will press V for Selection Tool, pick and needed lines, and press Ctrl or Command plus X to cut them. You can also press Q for the Lasso Tool, select Final Points, and press Ctrl or Command plus X twice to delete lines. Make sure that you'll delete all unneeded lines. You don't want to return to this step and fix your mistake later. After the last unneeded line is deleted, I recommend you to check everything. Make sure that this step is done and you are ready to continue. Then create a new layer and rename it to Lines. Copy all lines to this layer and lock it. After you lock this layer, make it invisible for now. Select Original Layer, press M for the Rectangle tool and create a rectangle. Bring this rectangle to the bottom of all layers. Now I'll press Ctrl or Command plus A to select Lines and Rectangle. Open Properties panel, More Options in Pathfinder, and select Divide. All lines are gone. They have separated rectangle into different shapes according to our tracing. So now we can ungroup these objects and turn the lines layer on to easily apply color. It's time to use the eyedropper tool. Press I to use it. You can select shapes one by one to adjust color, but I recommend you to group some objects to easily apply color for them in one click. In this case, you have a color palette and all that you need is to pick colors. But when you'll create your own illustrations, you'd like to experiment with colors. That's why I recommend you to create color groups. Hold Shift, select a few shapes, and press Ctrl or Command plus G to group them. In case if you'd like to change color for one object within a group, select it with the Direct Selection tool. We need to apply base colors first, so think only about raw color combination. Shadows and highlights will make everything look much more interesting, but you need to have a good base to apply them. There's the same technique for adding both, shadow and highlight. We'll use clipping mask. To do this, create a shape for a shadow or a highlight, then select needed object and make a copy by pressing Ctrl or Command plus C. After this, press Ctrl or Command plus Shift plus V to place copy on top. Select copy and highlight, right-click, and select Make Clipping Mask. That's it. I'll add shadows and highlights using only this method. There's only two things more you need to know. To change shadow, select and change it with the Direct Selection tool. To add shadow or highlight to the existing clipping mask, double-click on the clipping mask to enter isolation mode and create a shape inside. Then simply double-click to exit isolation mode. You can also create a shape outside of the clipping mask, then copy this shape, delete, enter the clipping mask isolation mode, and press Ctrl or Command plus F. In case if you're a beginner and it seems too hard for you, simply watch my previous tutorials where I explain each step and show everything slowly for beginners. Follow my reference to add shadows and highlights and to pick needed colors for them. Don't rush, take your time and feel free to experiment with color combinations. Don't hesitate to give yourself a break, it's important to stay inspired and be able to do your best. Let's create a custom brush to make lines look like a pencil sketch. First of all, create a new layer for a brush to avoid any confusion, then press N to use the pencil tool and create a noise like this. You'll be able to experiment with combinations on your own, and use any kind of little lines. They can be rounded or sharp, or even wavy. It's up to you. You can even create little triangles or rectangles and see what you'll get. Think of your brush radius while creating a noise. You'll be able to change radius anytime, but it's much more handy to match it as close as possible. I won't care about radius now because my goal is to show you how to adjust everything without any issues. Let's select this noise and group it. Then click on Object, Path, and select Outline Stroke. Change proportions like this. Then hold Alt or Option key and drag noise to make a copy. We need to create a long line. It should be straight, but not ideally. You can make it look rough by making this line a bit wavy. I recommend you to select a few noise prints and duplicate them at once. Rotate noise randomly to avoid symmetrical and boring look. Decrease opacity for noise prints at the start and at the end. This will imitate pencil pressure and the line will look more live and realistic. You should have a line like this. Select it all, open Brushes panel and click on the little menu of this window. Click on New Brush and select Art Brush. Rename this brush as you want. Don't change anything else for now and simply click OK. Now let's select a line and choose your custom brush. To adjust brush, double-click on it in the Brushes panel and use the slider to change size. After you'll click OK, select Apply to Strokes. You can select all lines and apply brush to all at once. But I'd not recommend you to do that because your Illustrator might crash. Also, if you'll see that your noise pattern stretches too much, press C for the scissors tool and cut it. Then use the Direct Selection tool to move points and make lines more live and interesting. If you learned something new from this tutorial, drop a comment below. Let me know if everything was clear enough for you and what you liked about this video. If you enjoyed this tutorial, support this channel by clicking on subscribe and what's most important, by clicking on the bell icon to get notifications about newest tutorials from TNT. I'd also appreciate if you'll click thumbs up and will share this video. This was TNT Tutorials. See you next videos!